welcome to another day of In the Garden with Pastor Evangelist Neil Gottman, planting seeds of hope from God's Word.
Well, good morning again. So good to have you with us in the garden today. I want to talk to you about something this morning that probably is a subject that we all need to understand a little bit better. I want to talk to you about patience. You know, James, when he wrote the book of James, he was writing to a group of people who had been scattered abroad throughout all the Asiatic continent and so forth because of persecution and so forth. And they knew, they believed that Jesus was coming back to redeem them and take them home. But they were anxious. They were anxious because they were going through some really challenging times. You and I go through challenging times almost every day, it seems like, in this fast-paced society and culture that we live in. It seems like patience really is difficult. It's a really difficult thing. But in the fact that that we know that Christ is coming again, that he's going to pick us up, he's going to take us out of the world, here's what James wrote. He said, "Be patient, therefore, brethren, until the coming of the Lord. Behold, the farmer waits for the precious produce of the oil, being patient about it until he gets the early and the late rains. You too, be patient. Strengthen your hearts, for the coming of the Lord is at hand." Are you looking for the coming of the Lord? Are you anxious for him to come? Are you being patient and saying, "Well, I'm going to live it out one day at a time, knowing that God is going to take care of me"? You know, I love going to the hymns because the hymn writers can say some things so much better than I seem to be able to say. There's a hymn entitled, "Until Then." He says, "My heart can sing when I pause to remember a heartache here in is but a stepping stone along a trail that's winding always upward. The troubled world is not my final home." You see, we need to just understand that the world is not our final home and that Christ is going to pick us up and take us out of this world. And until then, James says, we must be patient. We must understand that he's walking with us every day and he'll keep us along the way, but just be patient until he comes to take us out. He said, "The things of earth will dim and lose their value if we recall they're borrowed for a while. And things of earth that cause the heart to tremble, remembered there will only bring a smile." Remembered there will only bring a smile. Once we get there and we look back and we're going to say, "Why was I so concerned about that? Why was I so troubled about that?" Just be patient. Just wait for the coming of the Lord. He said, "This weary world, with all of its toil and struggle, may take its toll of misery and strife. The soul of man is like a waiting falcon. When it's released, it's destined for the skies." Do you know what, folks? One day, this old bowl of clay here is going to break wide open. And the angels are going to take my soul and take my spirit, and it's going to rise in the sky. And I'm going to have a new body, and I'm going to live forever with the Lord Jesus Christ. If I know that, which I do, and if you know that, which I pray that you do, just be patient. Wait for the Lord. He's got it all under control. He knows what your need is. He knows what your situation is. Don't let the world and the turmoil that goes on in this world pull you down. Just listen to him. Go to his word. Trust his word. Trust his promises. Believe that he will do what he says he will do. And one of these days, in the moment, in a twinkling of an eye, when the trump shall sound and the voice of the archangel, Jesus will shout, "Come up here." and we will go to be with the Lord. I pray that you have that confidence in Jesus today. Let it help you through the day. Let it be a blessing to you through the day. God bless you. Thank you so much for tuning in this morning.